Welcome to Monstrology, where we take a look at the killers, ghosts, monsters, demons, and other dangers of the horror world. I'm Griff Robodanger, and here at the world-famous Robodanger Institute, my team of monstrologists studies and analyzes all of the dangers one might encounter in a horror movie, so we can report our findings back to you. What are these dangers? How are they dangerous? And how do you survive? In this episode, we'll be looking at the original Friday the 13th from 1980.
What is the danger in Friday the 13th?
A psychotic killer named Pamela Voorhees.
Well, I'm Mrs. Voorhees.
Where does it happen?
At Camp Crystal Lake, a summer camp in rural New Jersey.
You're opening that place again?
Why does Mrs. Voorhees kill?
A little over 20 years earlier, Mrs. Voorhees was a cook at Camp Crystal Lake. Her young son Jason was also at the camp, but he ended up drowning in the lake because the camp counselors were too busy humping to notice a little bald kid bobbing up and down in the water. So now it's the present day, and a man named Steve Christie wants to reopen the camp. Mrs. Voorhees thinks this is a bad idea, and she's still pissed about her son drowning. The camp's impending launch triggers a grief-fueled rage in Mrs. Voorhees, who sets out on a killing spree to prevent the camp from opening.
Oh, I couldn't let them open this place again, could I?
Who are her victims?
Anyone associated with the camp, which includes owner Steve Christie, as well as all the camp counselors he hired to work there. In her fragile mental state, Mrs. Voorhees also starts to blame these new counselors for killing her son Jason, even though they would have been babies at the time, and nobody would hire a baby to be a camp counselor.
I've got six new counselors up at camp.
They are babies. Ease.
How does she kill?
Most of her victims are killed with a hunting knife, but she's also fond of arrows and axes.
How do you stop Mrs. Voorhees?
She's an older lady, so you wouldn't think she'd be tough to take down, but she's ridiculously strong and durable for her age. Still, her crazed mental state causes her to make errors in judgment, which you can take advantage of if you get your hands on a decent weapon.
How do you survive?
Mrs. Voorhees uses her harmless old lady persona to trick would-be victims. Who would suspect this nice grandma of being a vicious murderer? She's an excellent hunter and stalker, patiently laying in wait to take out her prey. You'll be murdered without even knowing you're in danger. As for survival tips, maybe don't take a job at Camp Crystal Lake. And never trust an old lady in a Jeep.
Quit.
Quit.
Quit now.
Why would I want to quit?
Now it's time for Sadistic Statistics, where we rate our horror baddie in four categories. Violence, viciousness, vitality, and versatility. Skeletronico, bring up the Sadistic Statistics Report.
Accessing the report.
First up, violence, a measure of body counts and bloodshed.
Violence score, 7.
Her kills are gloriously gruesome and bloody. Next is viciousness, a measure of evil, cruelty, or a general disregard for human life.
Viciousness score, 6.
She seems to enjoy terrorizing her victims and takes a sick pleasure in doling out justice for sweet little Jason. Next, we have vitality. How difficult is it to stop or kill this entity?
Vitality score, 3.
She's tough as nails, but she's still an old lady. Finally, versatility. How many ways can it get you?
Versatility score, 6.
She takes advantage of her victim's isolation with superior stalking skills and uses her old ladiness as a sort of camouflage to gain your trust before slicing your throat. That will close the case on the original Friday the 13th. Be sure to join us next time as we open yet another case file from the world of horror. Subscribe and ring that bell so future videos don't drown in the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, later, Danger Seekers.